Let's come to another property of acids and bases, that how do they react with metals? Isn't it? Now, metals are very reactive substances, and we are saying acid substances are also found in nature. In the sense, like a lemon juice, or if we say lemon pickle, all these sour substances which have been converted into pickle, and I store them in a container which is metallic. Now, whether it's possible for us to store, have you ever seen pickles being stored in metallic containers? Generally, they come in glass containers or they come in plastic container, isn't it? There might be reason for it. Why not a metallic container for storing pickle? Pickles are sour substances, so they contain acid. So there might be some reaction that's happening between the metal and the acid, which we will see. And what is the product of that? So we have ascertained the properties, one very important properties of acid bases. We didn't test any neutral substance. We'll do that later. First is use of indicators. A second property that I was telling you about is how do acids, reaction of acid and bases. With metals. If I have to write a general equation, chemical equation and reactions we've done in the first chapter. So if I have to write a general equation for this, a metal reacting with an acid produces salt plus hydrogen gases evolve. Alright, please look in the book. On page 20, we have that equation given. Acid plus metal gives salt plus hydrogen gas. Alright, now I'm going to demonstrate. We have taken a metal zinc granules. Alright, zinc is available in the form of granules in the lab. So when we test this activity, I put this granule in the test tube, alright, and I pour dilute H2SO4 in it. What do you expect to be formed? Can we see the gas? Can you see the bubbles coming out of it? And along with the gas being formed, what is being formed? Alright, so these bubbles are due to evolution of this hydrogen gas. Now if you know, you close the test tube with your thumb, you can actually feel the pressure of the gas being accumulated. Hydrogen is an inflammable gas. If you bring a burning, in the book they have also showed that if you bring candle near it, this hydrogen gas burns with a pop sound. This activity, because it requires, you know, burning of the candle, we'll do in the laboratory. But in the classroom, we've seen that the bubbles of hydrogen gas being released and the product formed is zinc sulfate. Now, linking it to what we had done in the last chapter, a metal, what metal we have taken? Zinc. Plus sulfuric acid is the formula for, sorry, H2SO4 is the formula for sulfuric acid. Please don't speak in chorus, alright? And the gas that is formed. Now what type of chemical reaction is? We had discussed the types of chemical reactions. Yes, you? It is a displacement reaction, alright? Zinc being more reactive than hydrogen has taken the place of hydrogen and you get zinc sulfate and hydrogen gas. We can carry out this reaction, say, with hydrochloric acid, then you will get zinc chloride, isn't it? You know, learn to write down these equations with as many metals and as many acids so that you get a practice of forming the compounds, and also then you will be able to balance the chemical equation, isn't it? If I have to write for zinc with hydrochloric acid, then it will be zinc chloride plus hydrogen gas. So what is the common thing happening here? Evolution of hydrogen gas in the reaction mixture. This is one property. Now do bases also react with metals? Yes. Do they, or do you expect them to react? What is the nature of metallic oxides and what's the nature of non-metallic oxides? Arushi?
Metallic oxides are bases.
So they don't react, isn't it? That's what we presume, that metals are supposed to be basic themselves. They are the origin of all the bases. If I say sodium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, they all contain sodium, calcium, potassium, which are metals themselves, isn't it? So do we expect metal to react with the base? But there are only two metals which react with the bases. And the reason for them being, they are amphoteric in nature. And those two metals which are reacting with base is zinc and aluminium. All right, zinc reacts with sodium hydroxide to form, which is sodium zincate, another type of salt. In this case also the hydrogen gases evolve. All right, this equation is given on page 20. The reaction that takes place can be written. You find again that hydrogen is formed in the reaction. However, such reactions are not possible with all the metals. The reason being, metals by themselves are sources of basicity of a substance. So you can't have a base and base reactive. Amphoteric means anything that can behave as an acid as well as a base. So zinc reacts with an acid too, and it reacts with a base too. So it is amphoteric in nature. The products that are formed are similar, salt and hydrogen gas. Clear? The third reaction that we have to discuss is, how do metal carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates react with acids? Ankit, give me an example of a metal carbonate.
Metal carbonate.
NaCl. NaCl is a salt, carbonate. Yes, Ritika? Please sit down. Na2CO3, sodium carbonate, sodium bicarbonate, calcium carbonate, all these are metal carbonates. Now, when you react a metal carbonate with an acid, let's see what happens. There's another activity that's given where we have taken sodium carbonate in a test tube or sodium hydrogen carbonate, and we will pour dilute HCl to both the test tubes. What do you observe? Let's see. If in a test tube I take sodium carbonate, sodium hydrogen carbonate, you know, is baking soda which is used in the kitchens. And then this sample A, which is acid. So when I pour this, can you see the effervescence of gas?
Yes.
These strong bubbles that are being produced in the reaction are due to evolution of carbon dioxide gas. Alright, so when a metal carbonate or a metal hydrogen carbonate react with an acid, then carbon dioxide gas is produced. If you have to write a general equation for this, we can write it in that form, which is written in the book on page 21. Metal carbonate, reaction of metal carbonate or a metal hydrogen carbonate. Acids. All right, so metal carbonate plus acid will give you salt plus, all right, this is the general equation you have to write. If you know the formula for the metal carbonate and you know the acid that you have poured in, correspondingly you're going to make a salt out of it, and then you will see the effervescence being produced. If practically you see, it's the carbon dioxide gas that is being produced. All right, let's take the example of sodium carbonate that we used plus HCl. Then you will have NaCl plus H2O and plus CO2. This was the gas that was being released in the reaction. Now carbon dioxide gas evolved. Like we tested hydrogen gas, I mean, I told you we can test hydrogen gas by bringing a burning candle near it. It will burn with a pop sound. Now to test the presence of carbon dioxide evolved in the reaction, it can be tested in lime water. What is the chemical formula for lime water, Himanshu?
Calcium carbonate.
Lime water.
Calcium hydroxide.
Calcium hydroxide. Alright, so when we pass this carbon dioxide through lime water, which is calcium hydroxide, this lime water turns milky. Alright? And the reason? Yes. The reason for this milkiness that appears when carbon dioxide gas is passed through calcium hydroxide is the formation of Calcium carbonate. All right, initially it forms calcium carbonate, but as you keep on passing more of gas at it, it forms calcium hydrogen carbonate, which is soluble. So that milkiness now disappears. That is what the reaction on page 20 and 21. Can you see? On passing the carbon dioxide gas evolved through lime water, you have first equation calcium hydroxide, which I have written on the board. The second equation is on passing excess carbon dioxide, the following reaction takes place and you have calcium hydrogen carbonate being formed, which is soluble in water. Clear? Now this we have discussed, the reaction of an acid with metals, reaction of metal carbonate with acid. But if an acid reacts with a base, what happens? You know, an acid is an acid. We are going to discuss about the chemical property or the chemical nature of acid on the basis of the ions which are present. An acid consists of hydrogen ions and a base consists of hydroxyl ions. Now what happens when you react an acid and a base together? They get neutralized with one another. So the end product is the salt that is produced and water. Alright, salt is supposed to be neutral. If it is a strong acid and a strong base that is reacting, then it's going to be neutral salt, and water obviously you know is neutral substance. If it is distilled water, we can't talk about the tap water or you know the water that you take from the rains, isn't it? So all these chemical properties that we have discussed today, let's quickly recap. First of all, I want you all to come on page 18. Page 18 of the book. In this table 2.1, where we had taken the sample solution. Now if you write, please write, fill up that table quickly with acid and base. Sample solution A, red litmus solution will change to, yes Ritika?
No change.
No change, because red litmus solution does not change its color when it is put in an acid. Then in case blue litmus solution changes to, yes Arushi?
It changes to red.
Changes to red, good. Phenolphthalein, yes Shikhar?
Colorless.
It's a colorless solution by itself, in the acid it stays colorless. And methyl orange solution, yes Arjun? In case of acid, it turns red. Good. Sample solution B was a base. So red litmus solution changes to, yes or no? It changes to blue. What is the color change of blue litmus? Yes, Anjana?
No change.
No change. Phenolphthalein? Yes, Gurmani?
Dark pink.
Dark pink. And methyl orange? Yes, Yog? It changes to yellow. Alright. So with the help of indicators, we can test whether that particular substance is an acid. Quickly coming to that question that we have in the book, you have been provided with three test tubes. One of them contains distilled water and the other two contain an acidic and a basic solution respectively. If you are given only red litmus paper, how will you identify the contents of each test tube? Yes, Akanksha, please answer this question.
Ma'am, we put red litmus paper in bases. If it changed to blue, we'll come to know that it's base. And in the other solution, if we put it, and if there is no change, then we can say it is acid. And if you put it in the distilled water, there will be no change.
Yes. So first of all, please sit down. Good. When you have to use that red litmus paper, now you've been given only one indicator, isn't it? And you've been given three solutions. So first of all, in three test tubes, you test those three test tubes, out of which we are saying one is acidic, one is basic, and one is neutral. So what you do is you put that red litmus solution in the test tube. It is going to change to blue. Now that litmus paper which you have used has become blue litmus paper, which now by itself is an indicator. Alright, so out of A, B, C, probably C is a base which we have now removed. Now we are left with only two test tubes which contain an acid or distilled water or a neutral substance. So when you take that blue litmus paper and put in a solution which is containing what? An acid, then that blue litmus will change to red again. Isn't it? So when that blue litmus paper changes to red again, we say that solution is acidic and the third one is then obviously neutral. Alright? Now quickly we'll come to the questions that are there on page 22. Why should curd and sour substances not be kept in brass and copper vessels? Yes, Anjana?
Because they are acidic in nature.
What are acidic in nature?
Curd and sour substances.
Yes, curd and sour substances are acidic in nature, and brass and copper vessel. Copper is a metal, you know. What's brass?
Alloy.
It's an alloy. It's an alloy of copper and
zinc.
All right. So you must have seen those substances reacting. As we have written, they are the reaction of metal with acids, isn't it? Now obviously those acids which are present in curd or other sour substances which consume are edible, but still they contain some acid in it, isn't it? The class of acid that we say is organic acid. So they might react slowly and they might spoil the food, which now does not remain edible. Isn't it? Obviously when some new substance is formed in a chemical reaction, you are using that pickle to enhance the taste of the food, isn't it? You're not going to eat something that has been now formed as a result of chemical reaction because of you storing that substance in a metallic container. Alright, that's why we do not get any sour substance available in a metallic container, because they react. And they react to produce what? Salt and hydrogen gas, isn't it? In that case, the edible substance might change to some non-edible kind of substance which we are not which will not be fit for us. Alright, which gas is usually liberated when an acid reacts with a metal? Illustrate with an example. How will you test for the presence of this gas? Yes, Shikhar, which gas is released when an acid reacts with metal?
Hydrogen gas.
I showed you the bubbles, please sit down. When the reaction for this is here itself, the same reaction, isn't it? When a metal reacts with an acid, hydrogen gas is being produced. How will you test for the presence of gas? I told you, you can bring a burning candle near it and then it's going to burn with the pop sound. Metal compound A reacts with dilute hydrochloric acid to produce effervescence. Now metal compound A, please focus on this. The gas evolved extinguishes a burning candle. Hydrogen is an inflammable gas by itself, but the gas that is being released here in this reaction is extinguishing a burning candle. Write a balanced chemical equation for the reaction if one of the compound is calcium chloride. Now one of the compound formed. Now what we have got, we've got one of the product as carbon dioxide gas and we've got one of the compound being formed as calcium chloride, which is a acid base or salt?
Salt.
Alright. So on the left hand side, acid is given dilute HCl. So which compound do you think? It's calcium carbonate. Alright. So you are reacting a metal carbonate with acid to produce salt plus carbon dioxide gas, and there is another product being formed which they've not mentioned. But these kind of questions, you know, can come as two marker questions. The reasoning behind it and writing down of chemical equation and balancing of the chemical equation in the CBSE paper, isn't it? So you should be able to write. Now they've taken one example. If I twist the question that metal compound A reacts with dilute hydrochloric acid to produce effervescence, the gas evolved extinguishes a burning candle, write a balanced chemical equation for the reaction if one of the compound formed is magnesium chloride. If I change the compound formed as magnesium chloride, then obviously you have to, yes. So the carbonate of magnesium we have taken, isn't it? So these kind of questions you should be able to, you know, write down yourself and practice with as many combinations. This is a general equation. Alright, or we can say standard equation, which can be modified by changing the carbonate that you have used, by changing the acids. So obviously the compounds formed would be different from whatever you are using, isn't it? Depends on that. So please treat question number 1, 2, 3 as your homework, and that's all we have for the day.